Hi, in this video we will use LaserShowGen to make a logo into a laser file that you can play on a LaserShow projector, either by exporting it as an ILDA file or by playing it directly through an ILDA port controller like the Helios Laser DAC. This whole tutorial can be done on the free version of LaserShowGen, so give it a try if you have not used the program before. LaserShowGen has several tools to make the tracing process easy and quick. The first thing we will do is import an image of the logo to the background of the canvas. This will make it easy to trace the logo and get it looking exactly right. To do this, simply press this IMG button below the canvas and choose your file. We will use this logo here as an example. Now we can start drawing the logo. The two shape tools that will be most useful for this is the line tool and the curve tool. We can start by drawing the outer edge of the logo. At first it may look like this circle here has a bunch of curves, but all of these segments on the outer edge is actually just straight lines, so we will use the line tool. Let's start with the first line here. But before we draw the next line, it's time to learn a useful trick. If you hold on the Alt key, the next line you draw will automatically start from the end of the previous line. That means you don't have to worry about positioning your mouse over every line segment exactly. All you have to do is focus on clicking on the next corner, and the connecting line will be drawn automatically, like this. We can just hold down Alt and then click on the next corner, and the lines will be automatically drawn. This makes tracing shapes like this much faster. So let's repeat this for the entire outer edge. Now we have reached this little circular arc in the center. The line tool is not the right tool to draw this. The circle tool is also not ideal because it creates a complete circle and we only want a portion of the circle. This lower part here is missing. We could technically use a dashed stroke type to color this section here black, but it's easier to just use the curve tool as mentioned earlier. When we use the curve tool to draw from the start of the curve to the end of the curve, we can see that this curve here appears. And there are some green lines too. We can drag the end of these green lines to adjust the curve. So let's try to make it match this arc in the center here. When we are happy with the curve, we can click Enter to finalize it. However, you can see we have a small problem. We can't get the curve to match exactly this circle. It looks kind of like an oval shape instead. So instead, we can undo this curve and use two curves combined for much more precise control. So let's draw the first curve halfway and then get it to match this perfectly. And then let's draw the other curve. I'm still using the Alt key trick to make this segment here automatically connect to the last one. That's much better. Now it matches the circle shape perfectly. Finally, let's go back to the line tool to draw this end segment here. And now it's time to connect these two final segments. We can use the Alt key to start automatically from the beginning, but how do we connect this to the end perfectly? Well, we can hold down the Q key, and then the line will automatically snap to the nearest edge. So then we can just hover close to here and finalize the line. By the way, if you forget all of these key shortcuts like Alt and Q, you can hover over the Help key here, and you get a nice list of all the key shortcuts in this window, at least unless you have disabled it in the settings. We are almost finished with our logo, but there is one problem left. All of these lines we just drew are white, because we forgot to change the color before we drew them, but we can change them after the fact. If we want to select the correct color to use, there is another trick. You can hold down the E key and then click wherever you want to clone the color. So you can see now that when we clicked, we selected the same color as the background image. So now we can select all the lines and then click Reapply Colors or Enter to color the lines correctly. If we now remove the background image by clicking the image button again, we have our final product. You can now play this file on your laser projector, either by exporting it as an ILDA file by clicking this button, or you can connect a compatible ILDA port controller like the Helios Laser DAC and play it directly if you set it up in the settings here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.